I'm Amy, and I am so excited about being featured on the Mom's View today. I have been following all of these women for years, and I just love this channel. I love everything that it represents, and so I'm super excited to be able to share my story with you guys. If you didn't know, I have a YouTube channel and it's called Team Darlie, so you can go check me out over there. I'm also on Instagram at Team Darlie, and I will just tell you guys a little bit about myself. All right, so I'm Amy and I have a husband named Chance, and we will be celebrating 10 years of marriage in just a few days. Our anniversary is June 21st, so we've been married for 10 years. We've been together for like, oh my gosh, 14 years now. So we also have two kiddos. I have a little boy named Kaysen, and he will be 7 on June 15th. And then I have a daughter, Gracie June, and she will be 5 at the end of July. So that's my little family. And we also have a dog named Cooper. And if you've seen my channel, he follows us around in all of my videos. He likes to be up under us all the time. He's super sweet. And we live in Savannah, Georgia. My husband was born and raised here, and I am actually from Middle Georgia, but we moved here after college. And I used to be a teacher. I was a teacher for 9.5 years before I became a stay-at-home / work-from-home mom. And my husband is in medical sales. All right, now that you guys know a little bit more about me, I wanted to share with you guys how I became a stay-at-home / work-from-home mom. It never occurred to me when I was younger that I would ever even want to be a stay-at-home mom. I always just thought, you know, I would want to work, and I knew I wanted a job that allowed me to be with the kids as much as possible when I had them one day. So I decided to be a teacher, and so I taught for 9.5 years, and I taught first, second, and third grade. Out of those 9.5 years, it was the grades that I taught, and I loved it. It was great. It was my passion. I loved doing it. I love being with the kids. But the moment that I had Kaysen, it all changed. Like, as soon as I had to go back to work after having him, my heart just broke in half, and I knew that I wanted to be a stay-at-home mom. But when Chance and I started talking about it, we were looking at our finances, and we just couldn't make it work. We had all this debt, which of course at the time we didn't think it was debt. We just thought, you know, it was normal. So we had 2 car payments, we had student loan debt, we had credit cards at that point, and we just, after looking at our finances, my husband made good money and I made good money, and together, I mean, it was great, but we had all this debt that was just soaking up all of our income. And Chance's company did not offer benefits, so if I were to cut my job out, we would have lost that salary. Plus, we would have had to fork out another $1,500 a month for benefits and pay all this debt that we were paying every single month. So it just was not possible. And then when Kaysen was a baby, I remember feeding him at night, and someone recommended this book called The Total Money Makeover, and I'd never heard of it before. I'd never heard of Dave Ramsey or any of that, but I remember sitting there reading the book in the middle of the night while feeding him every single night. And it was so good. I shared it with my husband and kind of explained it to him, and we both thought it was the best idea. But that was pretty much as far as it went. I was still praying every single day, please let me be a stay-at-home mom. Please let me figure out how we can make this work. But I was doing nothing about it. And then 2 years later, I had Gracie June, and the same thing happened. You know, especially after I had her, it was like, oh my goodness, like, I have both my kids in daycare and I'm working full time. I want to be at home with them so bad, and we just couldn't do it. We still had all this debt. We actually, at this point, had put a screen porch on our back porch, and we were financing that. So we just added even more debt to the whole scenario. So then Gracie June was probably about 2 when we started listening to the Dave Ramsey show on the internet, and then I would also listen to podcasts while I would run or in the car or wherever, and it was so motivating. I got Chance started listening to it, and we were hearing about it at church. We had friends that had done Financial Peace University, and so we were just super interested in going back to the Total Money Makeover. It's the whole, you know, it's the same plan, but at that point we were like, okay, you know, whether I get to stay at home or not, we need to get rid of this debt. neither one of us grew up learning about finances. I feel like we were just financially dumb and just thought, well, as long as we can afford the payment, then, you know, we're doing good. It's not debt if you can afford it, right? So we just had all the stuff that we were just forking out money on every single month. So at that point was when we made the decision to get out of debt, whether it was for me to stay at home or whether, you know, if God willing, that was we were able to do that, but we needed to get out of debt, period. So we started the Dave Ramsey Financial Peace University plan, and we put $1,000 in the bank for savings because that's the first step. And then after that, we started on our debt snowball. We were budgeting every single dime, every single month. We were not eating out at all. And if we wanted to eat out, it was a $5 pizza from Little Caesars that we would do once a week, and that kind of filled our little void of eating out. And then about a year later, after we had started, we were about halfway through our debt snowball, and it was feeling so good. We couldn't believe how much progress we had made. Chance got offered a job opportunity. It was with the same sort of, like, he was doing the exact same thing, but it was with a different company, and they offered benefits. So this was a total game changer for us. He decided to take the job, and at that point, we still had so much debt, though, that we knew we had to get this debt taken care of before we could even think about the possibility of me staying at home. So it's a year after we started our debt snowball. We're halfway through our debt snowball. Chance is switching jobs and now has benefits. And we decided to step it up even more, and we sold our house. We went and rented a house that was half the size of ours, and we were paying like $500 less a month. And we were able to throw that into our debt snowball as well. And then at the same time that we did that, I started an Etsy shop trying to make some extra income to throw onto all of our debt and pick up the speed even more. And then after a year of working full-time as a teacher, working my Etsy shop, and Chance had been switched over to his new company for a year, we finally paid off all of our debt and we're completely debt-free. And we are so excited. We built our house after that, and I decided that I was going to just stay at home and be with my babies. So now, this past year, I was a stay-at-home/work-from-home mom because I would do my Etsy shop, and I was able to go to every single program. I go to my kids, they're both in school now. So Kaysen was in first grade last year, and Gracie June was in pre-K. So I went and ate lunch with them every single week, volunteered in the classroom, went on their field trips, and got to do everything that I had dreamed of. It's been the best year ever, and it was so totally worth it for all that work that we did. And I only wish that I had done it sooner, or that someone had told me about Financial Peace University, or even just finances, period, way before we even got married, so I never would have had to do all of that. I do think it made me stronger, it made our marriage stronger, and it made us look at finances in a completely different light. So I think we're gonna be so much better off in our future because of taking that course. So I shared my story with you guys because I'm hoping that it will help at least one person out that has that feeling in their heart that they want to be a stay-at-home mom and doesn't think that it's possible. It took me 6 years, but we finally made it happen. The first 3 years, all I did was pray about it. And then God put this program into our lives and people into our lives that helped us learn more about our finances and everything, and we were able to finally make it happen. And I hope that this gives you guys some encouragement too. All right, so thank you again to The Mom's View for having me on your channel. I am so honored to be a part of this, and if you are at all interested in checking out my channel, make sure you go check it out at Team Darley. I do lots of lifestyle vlogs, cleaning, home decor, things like that, so if you are into those types of videos, make sure you come check me out, and I will see you guys later. Bye!